Who am I? What do I do for a living? Actually, my name's Pete, and I'm an IT specialist. I heard about this amazing Russian invention, and I came here to check it out. By the way, I'm in Moscow.
Part of the problem with navigation in Russian is the language. You don't have time to read the names of the streets. You've got to stop to look at a map.
Russians, ask them for help. Some try to help you, some don't. Those who do try to help you, 90% of it I don't understand. They're just pointing and waving their arms. So I ended up getting a GPS. It's useful, but it's not completely useful.
If you have to take a diversion, you need to stop to type in the new address. And if you miss the last voice instruction, you've got to look down to press the button. You can't take your eyes off the road for too long. It's just not safe. And on the road, especially in Russia, anything can happen. So, I'm at the right place. Looks more like a factory than an office. Most startup companies progress from a garage or backyard, hopefully to Silicon Valley. Maybe the trend in Russia is to start from a factory.
Yes. Hello, Peter.
These guys showed me the working drawings of the helmet with the navigation system built in. It looks really impressive.
We started our project 5 years ago and had nothing, but we had a very cool idea, a motor helmet with augmented reality mode. It's new era for motorcycles with our gadget. It's a helmet from Iron Man.
The final version of the helmet is going to be made out of carbon fibre. It's high-strength material, which is stronger than steel, but this material is very light. The helmet will be certificated by international standards. So, what did they change in the construction of the helmet? It's slightly bigger than an average helmet, so that the picture can be projected onto the visor. Same technologies used in aviation helmets, and in the new BMW cars.
We try to make our interfaces as simple and as friendly as possible. The picture is always in focus. You don't have to switch from the road to the interface. You just look through it and see the interface and the road at the same time.
When you're moving at high speed, you see the minimum information. The picture is not very big, it's in the center. That's the human eye's focus zone.
Our helmet features voice control. We conducted several tests in various noisy conditions and results are quite good. The confidence level is up to 95%.
I wonder, does it only understand the Russian accent?
Enter address.
Same street name in San Francisco.
Market Street.
Excellent.
Actually, the technology is the same as Siri in the iPhone. And how long does the battery last?
The battery life is always a problem. You will not have it.
They told me it lasts for the whole day.
This long time is achieved by use of extended batteries. You can charge your helmet with the usual USB cable.
Well, the idea itself is really interesting. But are these guys going to be able to roll up the product?
For this moment, we have a lot of prototypes, any parts of our final helmet.
They already have a Skolkovo Innovation Center grant, as well as venture funds.
The grant committee gave to the project $1 million grant to develop the helmet. We decided that this project have a good market perspective. I strongly believe that he will be successful, and I wish him the best of luck.
Despite the fact that the invention is Russian, in the first instance, the helmet's going to be released in English-speaking countries because the voice recognition technology is adjusted for the English language as being the most popular. And what about the price? $2,000 US. But if you're an early bird, $1,500 US. Well, I hope I'm going to get it for free for taking part in this demo. After all I've seen, I told my friends about the invention. They really like the idea.
I believe our gadget will be very helpful for any motorcyclist, and I ask you to help our project.